Inside the Show with Justin Allegri.
Hi, I'm Justin Allegri, and this is your Wednesday edition of Inside the Show. Looking first at the American League East,
Carlos
Cobra got the win number 7 thus far as the Ducks defeated the Orioles 7-2. He is among the AL leaders in wins. And that'll do it for today. Enjoy the games, and we'll talk to you tomorrow.
Hello, baseball fans, and welcome. The show has an AL East matchup. It's the Ducks taking on the Baltimore Orioles. John Shambi along with Chris Singleton. Singy, we're going to see a lengthy win streak put to the test here today.
Well, when you're winning like this, it's a fun place to be. In the dugout and in the clubhouse, the music is loud after the ball games. The food tastes great. I know this team wants to keep it going.
Just about set to go now. And starting this one, John Means.
Yeah, Boog, he went deep into the game last time, only allowed one run, but he took a tough loss. Got to bounce back from those quickly and know that today's a new day. You can get that W.
So just about set now, and now it's going to be Lawrence Cohen.
Leading off for Long Island, the shortstop, Lawrence Cohen.
The pitch. Ah, that hit him. And the leadoff man is aboard to start the inning. And now here's the speed threat. Outfielder Mikey Cohen. Means throws over. Cohen dives back in safely. Next pitch downstairs. And that's ball one. Runner at first with no outs here. Next pitch is outside.
Good speed on the base paths. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
Pickoff move to first. Cohen back in standing. Popped up to the left into foul ground. Well, makes the play, and there's one down. Let's take a look at our lineup, and a key factor for this club in that leadoff spot, Lawrence Cohen.
Yeah, definitely someone I always enjoy, you know, when I get a chance to watch him, whether he's hitting a game or even taking swings during batting practice. Man, this guy is always so focused on what he's doing on that task at hand. He's got so much attention to detail that when he steps in the box, his success rate is really high.
Stephen Cohen takes a ball here as he stands in now. Means throws over. Cohen back on a dive. Cohen over at first with one away.
Two balls, no strike.
That one is absolutely belted. That's back. And it's gone. He flexes his power with that swing. His 18th home run of the season. And they jump out front. It's 2-0.
When you're working with this kind of velocity, so critical that you move the ball around, work quickly, and make sure that you keep that hitter off balance. Clearly not fooled by the location or the velocity. He was all over that fastball.
The third base. Next to hit, Oliver the man.
The man.
Still only one out here in the inning. The next offering misses. Yeah, the count 1-2. Nice warm day here, good baseball weather. Does that change anything, Chris, especially for the hitters?
Absolutely. You feel so much more comfortable at the plate. You're not worried about getting jammed on fastballs inside part of the plate. You can kind of be more selective instead of just looking out away so that you can get the barrel to it in that part. You can get on the inside part of the plate as well.
Ben Witt in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. The why to kick the pitch. Swing and a miss. And the count is 0-2. Next offering is in the dirt. And a ball evens the count.
He's trying to stay down in the zone, but the hitter just will not chase. Now back in a 2-2 count, he's going to have to go to something else to get him out.
Oh, now this one's high and deep, way back there, on its way, gone. He powers one out to right field. It's his sixth home run of the season, and they add a run. It's 3-0.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
So up next, Spencer Savage.
Batting six, the right fielder.
First pitch, and he just misses.
Well, they're really running up the pitch count in this first inning. Lots of confidence from this team that is perhaps the hottest in baseball right now.
Fly ball down the line. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. It's now 3-0. Bottom of the first. And today's starting pitcher, Dan Larsen. And Singy, as you know, he took home the AL Cy Young Award last year.
Very impressive. It's so hard to turn over an American League lineup because of the DH and because of the emphasis on offense and home runs. But he was able to navigate through lineups last season. I think he's going to be great again this season.
Cedric Mullins stands in now and lets that one go for a strike. Yoan. Just missed.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Swing and a miss, and now 2-2.
That was straight queso right there.
And a pitch. This to center field. The Bambino drifts towards it. Hauls it in, and there's one away. All right, let's take a look at the Orioles lineup now. Batting seventh, someone they're hoping breaks out in this one, Adley Rutschman.
Yeah, he's really slumping at the plate right now. Not only is he having a hard time finding any base hits, he's just not finding a way to get on base either. Sometimes a walk can get you back on track. Less than a 250 on-base percentage over his last 10 games. So that kind of tells me that he's jumpy, he's not recognizing the pitches, and he's out of his plate discipline. I got to think he's looking for ways to try to simplify that approach. And I think if you can just let the ball travel a little bit deeper, make sure you see it, that will help you to put good ABs together. And even if you don't get hits, you'll draw some walks.
They say it went. And the pitch stays alive. One down, base is empty. And one and two. And that's downstairs and outside. And the righty deals. Got him looking. Two out.
Well, definitely a borderline pitch right there, and he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. You know, those are tough ones to let go as a hitter, but with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with two strikes.
Two outs, base is empty, and now it's Austin Hayes. First pitch doesn't find the zone. This one high in the air to left center. The Bambino under it. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And that'll do it. 1-2-3 go the Orioles. They trail in this one 3-0. Back here at the ballpark, all set for the start of the inning. And now the center fielder, Andrew the Bambino. I think when you contemplate him as a player, the first thing you think about is defense, and you think about that great arm.
I also think about the speed. If he can get on, that's going to give one more thing for that pitcher to think about.
So two balls and no strikes.
Boog, one of our favorites. Jerry Hillsdale umpiring behind home plate in this one. Pretty much by the book with his strike zone.
And because he's so by the book, you'll sometimes see pitchers questioning him. They'll make a good pitch on the edge of the zone, want the strike, and not get the call. But most of the time, Jerry gets it right. He's a good one. Quips it to Mountcastle. One up, one down.
Fastball groove right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air, maybe drive it into the gap.
And now Sonny Song. He has, as they like to say, light tower power. Not a big guy, but a big swing and thunder in that bat. First offering way inside, almost got him. Left-hand hitter waits. Just missed.
He's been raking in recent games, and a big reason why, getting ahead in counts. He's been able to do that consistently, and you see the results.
The next pitch misses. Three balls, no strikes. Left-hand batter waits. There's a strike.
I think it was sitting off speed right there because he just let the fastball go by.
Popped up. And there's two down.
Batting ninth, the second baseman, Al Moose.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the second baseman, Al Moose. Good power, not great in the OBP department. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
This strong second inning is a confidence builder for him, a relief for his manager. Doesn't have to get into that bullpen quite as early.
And that one lifted in the air center field. That's a hit, and that extends the inning.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate, and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
Cohen batting for the second time, and that's strike one. Next offering misses, and it's a ball and a strike.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Moose, the runner at first with two gone. Next pitch is outside. Kicks and fires. Off the mark there. Three balls and a strike.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
And now the lefty, 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
Here's a speed threat, Mikey Cohen. He's a guy who does it all. In there, and it's 0-1.
When you're struggling out there on the mound, hitters know that there'll be plenty of opportunities within the at-bat to try to get something to hit hard.
First and second, two down. Next offering is in for a strike.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple of strikes. Now back is against the wall. He's going to have to figure something out and figure it out quickly.
And there's a foul ball.
You know, he can move the ball around, add and subtract, get some weak contact at times. So you don't worry as much about him in this situation. Very capable of getting a ground ball. And
got him. That's the third out.
Hotline blinging, hotline ringing. Why they keep calling me? I don't judge, but your fake case closed, and I ain't got a law degree. Can't understand why they all on me. I'm crazy, don't get involved with me. I drop the top and feel this autumn breeze. You need gas till we can be all on E.
Here's Ryan Mountcastle, swinging it much better this season in away games than here at home.
The Orioles, the first baseman, Ryan Mountcastle.
Larson back to work. And a good eye there.
A 3-0 lead is great, but you can't get too comfortable. Got to stay aggressive, keep attacking hitters, try to cruise through this ball game.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Two balls, no strikes, the count.
2-0 count to a guy like this at the plate. You've got to throw a pitcher's pitch. Don't just try to get a strike. He could make you pay.
That one's spoiled, and the count now 2-1. Good eye in that spot. Next offering finds the zone and the count is full.
Goodness, I think he just took the best pitch he's going to see in this at bat. You don't get many like that in that location. I don't know if you take that pitch against any pitcher out there on the mound.
And it's ball four. He missed down low.
I don't think he really wanted to pitch to him right there anyhow.
Trey Mancini now.
The designated hitter, Trey Mancini.
In there for strike one.
There it was, a high velocity fastball in the zone. I think a little frustration from walking the previous hitter. He's got good stuff. Pitch inside the zone and trust it.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Good approach right there. You want to get something just a little higher that you can elevate. Stay out of that double play.
And the 0-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Righty to the plate. Pitch misses there. Now 1-2. Nobody out. Runner at first. Next offering in the dirt. It's 2-2. Here comes a pitch. Runner on the go. Stays alive. And a pitch. Slice to right. Can't get there. Base hit. Mountcastle headed for the plate. Cohen with a relay home. Not in time. He scores. And it's now a two-run game.
Drove that ball nicely. Put a great swing on it. And it jumped off his bat. Kind of put it all together there. And he's rewarded with the double.
Anthony Santander at the plate.
Batting six. The right fielder, Anthony Santander.
And first offering is fouled off. And that one just missed off the outside edge. Ground ball to the right side. Witt takes it to the bag. That's one out in the bottom of the second.
Batting seven. The catcher, Adley Rutschman.
Here's Adley Rutschman.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
In the dirt, blocked. And the runner holds. One away with a runner at third. Bounced up the middle. Moose gloves it. Now two away as they get a run across. Nick Ahmed here to hit. Really thriving with the bat this season here at home. Yeah, And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
And the 0-1. Now 1-1.
1-1.
And the right-hander deals. Swing and a miss as he was out front.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there. It just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment.
Cut on and miss. Struck him out. Out number three. We head on now to the top of the third. The Ducks with the lead in this one. 3-2. Welcome back. Top half of the third inning. And now the catcher comes up to him. Stephen Cohen.
The catcher. Stephen.
The big lefty turns, kicks, deals.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on. See if you can get a stolen base. Maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
And here it comes. And now 2-0.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have to keep the discipline so that you're not popping up pitches that are just a little too high.
Steps on first for the out.
Now batting, the third baseman, Oliver, the man.
Here's a big power threat, Oliver, the man.
Not only can he hit the cover off the ball, he's got a great eye as well.
And that's in there for strike one.
Well, he looks fresh out there. Just needs to get a little more confidence and remember how good he's been in the past.
The pitch. There's the swing and a miss.
That's one of those swing now before the pitcher's even let go of the baseball.
The 0-2. Just misses with that one.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Kicks and deals.
That's a ball. 2-2 down.
He swings and fouls one off. The 2-2. Bounding ball here, rolls foul. The pitch. And he chases that one. Two away. And here's the first baseman, Ben Witt. This splits between April and May there. That one's in there, 0-1. The wind of the pitch. That one misses, and it's 1-1. Yeah, that's outside. That one in for a strike, 2-2. And now the count filled up, 3-2.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off speed to the fastball, and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
And a swing and a miss. And the inning is over. back here in Baltimore as we go to the last of the third. Now the third baseman, Toby Welch.
The third baseman, Toby
Welch. Larson back to work. There's the strike.
Well, triple digits on the gun. I know there are more guys that can reach that now than in the past, but it's still impressive to watch.
And now the count is even. The wind and the pitch. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Witt makes the grab, and there's one down.
The batter, the center fielder, Cedric.
Here's the center fielder, Cedric Mullins.
Looking at the way that you dance, I want to know where you from. Left cheek, right cheek. How you getting them jeans?
First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Well, we call that keyholing. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
Next offering is in for a strike. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. That's out number two.
Flipped that screwball up there and got him to swing through it. It's kind of part changeup, part curveball, a reverse curveball, I guess, and clearly, it's got some good movement on it. We just don't get to see a good one very often, so it's kind of fun to see, and that was a great one right there.
And next for the Orioles, Connor Norby. First offering misses the mark.
Ball one, no strike.
Just off the outside edge.
Well, he looks more focused at the plate and working the count after that first at-bat strikeout.
The pitch. That one drilled left field. Can't get there, and now maybe extra bases. And the double puts the tying run in scoring position with two away.
A little more backspin on that instead of the top spin. He's jogging around the bases rather than pulling up at second.
So two down and into the box for Baltimore, Austin Hayes. 0-for-1 with a fly. Next offering is down low, and it's 1-0. And he gets that fastball by him upstairs.
Well, baseball is coming out of his hand very well. He's been able to paint all four corners, but really good ride at the top of the zone. Hitters have to respect that. Very difficult pitch to hit.
Norby on its second with two down. This one chopped up the middle. Throws to first. That ends the inning. On to inning number four. The Ducks with the advantage on the scoreboard, 3-2. Back now at Oriole Park. Start of the fourth. And now Spencer Savage.
The right fielder. Spencer.
And he deals.
Savage.
Swing and a broken bat flare. On the run, throw to first. One up, one down.
Got to feel pretty good for the pitcher. Absolutely sawed him off. Bat explodes. And then he makes an easy play on it. Pretty satisfying if you're out there on the ball.
Now it's the power speed combo. Andrew the Bambino. And first offering is fouled off. Next offering is fouled back. The 0-2. And fouled off. And a pitch. Gonna count 1-2.
Well, this is a guy that can be frustrating for pitchers because he fouls off so many pitches and grinds out the at-bat. I'm sure there's some times where a pitcher would rather just give up a first pitch single than have to waste 6 or 7 pitches on one hitter.
Mountcastle has a bead on it, squeezes it. 2 down.
Boy, that was a hanging breaking ball right there. I think he tried to do a little bit too much. Sometimes those eyes can get really big. I think his swing broke down as well, and that's what caused him to pop it up.
So now here's the DH, Sonny Song. 0-for-1 so far. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. Next pitch, not close, up high. Bounce to the right. Norby collects it. Throw to first is in time. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. And welcome back. Ready to go. Bottom four. Here's the Oriole cleanup hitter, Ryan Mountcastle.
The first baseman, Ryan Mountcastle.
The pitch. That's outside. Ball one. And the pitch. In the air, right side. And out number one on the grab.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Trey.
And next is the designated hitter, Trey Mancini. And the first pitch misses for ball one. There's a strike. Strike two.
Now there's a certain point where you have to commit to what you think you see, and he guessed wrong right there. Nasty slider with just terrific bite at the end.
And now it's even up. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Two outs, bases empty. Anthony Santander getting ready to hit. In there, and it's 0-1.
0-1's the count.
Two down, nobody on. Stays alive. The pitch. That one not close. And the count is 1-2. And the pitch. Left field. Cohen on the move. Brings it in. And that will end the inning. Nothing doing this time around for the O's. They trail it 3-2. We go to the top of the fifth. And the batter now, Al Moose.
Leading off for the Ducks.
Well, Boog, after watching the first inning of this one, you would not have expected that this pitcher would be in such a groove and still in the ballgame at this point.
That's a strike. Strike one. Well, it was bumpy in the early going for the lefty, but he settled into a really nice groove. Slapped foul. Kicks and fires. And he hits a ground ball right side, and it goes just foul. Here's the 0-2. This one popped up. Mountcastle settles under it. Makes the grab, and there's one away.
Well, that was a pitch you got to crush. Now unbelievable that he missed it right there, and I'm telling you, he is going to be frustrated with himself until his next at bat.
Here's some real power at the plate. Lawrence Cohen. Rolled over to third, and it gets by him. That extends his hitting streak to an even dozen, Zingy. Do opposing pitchers start to take notice when a guy's on a roll like this?
Yeah, I think so, Boog. It's not like it changes the scouting report on a guy or anything like that too much, but you're aware of who's swinging the hottest bat, and that's definitely him right now.
Runner on at first with one gone. Now at the plate, Mikey Cohen. Means keeping him close. Runner on the go. High fly ball, right field. Santander under this one. And puts the squeeze on that one. And there are two down.
Now batting, catcher, Steven Cohen.
Steven Cohen, the next to hit. And this is a guy that doesn't just impact the game defensively. They count on him to deliver offense.
He's the first guy at the ballpark. He's got to study opposing hitters. He's got to get familiar with his starting pitcher for that night. And he's getting in the cage to take his swings. That's a whole lot, and so many times goes unnoticed.
The lefty, the 1-0. There's a strike. And now 2-1. Means throws over. Cohen back in on a dive. Cohen off of first with two away. Two-one pitch is in there, and the count is even.
Back-to-back fastballs in. That last one called for a strike. Probably go away, but look for him to come back in there to try to finish you off.
Next offering upstairs.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
And here's a 3-2. So now two on and two outs.
So close to getting out of it right there, but this inning still has life.
Now batting.
Oliver, the man, digs in now. So RBI spot, but Chris, this is a guy that is not really swinging the bat all that well here.
In this situation, you have a real good opportunity to get swings and misses and record a strikeout. I think you attack him in this spot.
That one ripped. Drops for a hit. He couldn't run it down. One run is in. Cohen around third. Throw, and it gets away. The run scores all the way from first, and they're up by three.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm front side, and the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
Here comes the manager out of the dugout, and he'll make a move for the bullpen. That's as far as John Means will go. It's a three-run game, and we'll be back to tell you about the new arm in a minute. So they turn to the lefty in this spot, Tim Hill. A runner on second to deal with. He'll do his best to keep him there.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and we need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
So two down now, and here is Ben Witt. In there for strike one. Man on second, two down. Runner breaks for third. Throw to third. Ow! And that will end the inning. But they'll pick up a couple runs here, both coming on this two-run double. It's now 5-2. Back here at the ballpark, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Now the Orioles catcher, Adley Rutschman.
The catcher, Adley.
Here comes a pitch.
Rutschman.
Just missed.
Well, the offense has gotten going, and a pitcher wants to go out there, have a real quick inning, get those guys back into the dugout so those bats can stay hot.
Next offering is in for a strike. And the righty deals.
Two ball, one strike, count.
And that one fouled off. Left-hand batter waits. And now it's filled up. And a 3-2. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Cohen makes the play, and there's one down.
Oriole Park, still one of the most beautiful ballparks in all of baseball. I can't say another franchise does it better than Baltimore. The opening day ceremony, the players come in from the outfield through the center field wall, long orange carpet, so many fans here. Just a great place.
Andy 0-1. Late on that fastball. That signature warehouse in right field as well. You talk about knowing where you are, a sense of place. I mean, who could forget Griffey hitting the home run off of the warehouse in the home run derby? But always when shots are framed, you see that building, you know exactly where you are, Camden Yards. Righty to the plate. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Out number two.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching, is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Guys become defensive, and all of a sudden, for the hitter, that plate starts to get really wide. And what happens is, because of the pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout.
Well, in the box for the second time, one ball, no strikes. in the air, right field. Drops into the glove. That is the inning. Three up, three down for the Orioles. They trail at 5-2. Welcome back. Start of the sixth, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton. And leading off, Ben Witt.
The first baseman, Ben Witt.
The pitch. That one inside, and that's ball one. And here it comes. In there at the knees. And now the lefty. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2.
One thing on his mind right there with that swing. He's trying to go deep.
Next one misses, and a full count now.
He's got one already tonight. I wouldn't be surprised if he pops another one here.
And a pitch. Foul ball there. Three, two. Fought off foul. The pitch. On the ground, right side, and foul ball. Three, two on the way. Down. And one gone.
Well, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
Spencer Savage now at the plate. This to third, and it finds its way through for a hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Got the top of the ball a little bit, but not much. That was hit pretty hard through the infield, so I think he'll be happy with that swing. Definitely generated some good bat speed. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Runner on the move. And a pop-up. Right side, foul territory. Mountcastle makes the grab. Two down.
The batter, the designated hitter, Sonny Song.
Man at first. Next to hit, Sonny Song. Pickoff throw, and he's back in safely. Runner, runner. Here's the pitch, runner on the goal. Ball misses. Throw there, safe. That was close, but StatCast shows us why he so often seems to be on the safe side of these steal attempts, Chris.
Yeah, you see that plus speed, and he needed every last bit of it to swipe that bag. Such a threat on the bases.
Intentional walk here with two out, They set up a force at any base to end the inning.
Clearly didn't want to mess with them right there, so I think it makes sense now to play the numbers game in this spot.
The second baseman.
First and second, two down.
Moose.
And stepping in is the speedy Al Moose. And that's in there for strike one.
Some guys are just more confident if they can track that first pitch out of the hand of the pitcher. They don't care if they fall behind 0-1.
At the belt and fires. Right through there for a strike.
All right, now, he may have not liked either of those first two pitches or agreed with the umpire's calls, but at this point, he's going to have to bear down and be ready to hit anything close to the zone.
Next pitch downstairs. It's a ball and two strikes. Two outs. A couple of base runners at first and second. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Two on, two outs. And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. He can't get there. That should be extra bases. Runner around third and to score. Another scores. Two runs in on the play. It's 7-2.
Gets the job done as he brings home a pair. He put a great swing on that ball. Took the barrel right to it. Nice extension as well. 105 exit velocity. That tells you everything you need to know about that swing.
Here's the shortstop at the plate, Lawrence Cohen. That one's in there, 0-1. Moose stands at second with two gone. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Swing and a line drive. Base hit out of the center field. Run comes in from second. It's 8-2.
Right there, he does a great job of staying in the big part of the field. Man, there are a lot of hits there.
Mikey Cohen.
Keegan Aiken into the game. Big deficit here, but he's still got a job to do.
Number 45, Keegan Aiken.
So digging in, Mikey Cohen. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Kicks and deals. And he grounds one back up the middle. Whips it to Mountcastle. That's out number three. To the bottom of the sixth inning. The Ducks out front 8-2. Well, we go bottom six, and now the center fielder, Cedric Mullins.
Leading off for the Orioles.
Well, every pitcher wants a run support, and having a lead is nice, but it can be challenging for some guys. I think keeping the mindset to attack instead of trying to be too fine and have too much finesse, go after hitters and get quick outs.
So two balls and no strikes. And a foul ball. The 2-1. That one fouled off. Next offering is fouled back. Righty delivers. Swings and crushes one. Right field, way back and gone. Cedric Mullins sends it out. His seventh home run of the season. And they're chipping away. It's 8-3.
A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
Now the number two hitter, Connor Norby.
Now that's the second baseman, Connor.
First offering misses the mark. And the right-hander deals. Two balls, no strikes, the count.
With the big bats coming up and a home run already surrendered, he's really going to have to execute against these next couple of batters.
In the air, center field. The Bambino settles underneath it, makes the catch. One away.
Now back.
So up next, Austin Hayes.
Well, they kept him pretty quiet in this series. Still doesn't have a knock. I know you want to get that first knock out of the way. Maybe more will come, but you got to give some credit to the pitching staff. They've had a great plan against him.
The wind of the pitch. That's out to center field. The Bambino settles underneath it, makes the grab for the second out.
Up next for the Orioles, the first baseman, Ryan.
And now the first baseman, Ryan Mountcastle. He's 0 for 1. In there for strike one.
Not what he's looking for there in the 0-0 count. Looks like he wants the ball down in the zone.
Fouled off. He was late. Oh, and two now. Ball one there.
I don't think he was trying to miss by that much in an 0-2 count. Just tried to overthrow that pitch.
Two outs. And it's even up. And that just misses. Why to kick the pitch. And that one fouled off. Hit pretty well in the air out to center. The Bambino makes the catch, and that'll do it. Solo homer brings in one for Baltimore. It's now 8-3. There's a river in a valley headed towards me. I cut my coolers, got my head back, and it's going in. Back here in Baltimore, new inning getting started. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Stephen Cohen.
The catcher, Stephen.
The wind and the pitch. Strike one. The pitch. And now the count is even. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and that's the first out.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but now that time, a little anxious.
Oliver, the man.
At the plate, Oliver, the man. Good contact guy, good defender. That one hit to right. Santander on the run towards the line. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Two down.
The first baseman, number 23. Ben.
Two outs, bases empty. Here's a big power threat. Ben Witt. He's already homered in this game. In there, and it's 0-1. There's a strike.
I wouldn't say the game's close right now, but it's not out of reach either. I mean, these guys really need to put up a zero on the board just to maintain a little hope.
That one ran inside, almost got him. One and two here. Next offering is outside. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Mountcastle makes the catch, and that'll do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join us for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Dan Palmer hasn't pitched in the last 3 days. Now it's the DH, Trey Mancini, 1-for-2.
For the Orioles, the designated hitter, Trey Mancini.
And the pitch. And a foul ball. Right-handed reliever. Foul ball. Got him swinging. He chased the changeup. One out.
Now, when you follow up a triple-digit fastball with a nasty changeup, pretty much every time the hitter's going to be in trouble. That was the plan. Get him to sit dead red on the fastball and then just make him look foolish with the off-speed stuff.
So next to hit for Baltimore, Anthony Santander. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Palmer, a very difficult guy to get hits off of. It's really rare for teams to string stuff together against him.
He wins every pitch. And for a hitter, sometimes a victory is just fouling off one of his pitches.
And there's the strike.
Unless he beats himself, somehow can't find it, doesn't have the control command that day, you can pretty much forget about it.
Swings and blasts one deep to left center. That one's back. And it's gone! Anthony Santander knocks one out. His 12th of the season, it's 8-4.
That's the exact definition of hitting the ball where it's pitched, taking that outside fastball and driving it the opposite way out of the ballpark. You want to bottle that type of approach.
And the batter now, Adley Rutschman. First pitch, just misses. As a hitter, there's even more pressure to take advantage of any mistake, right?
Yeah, and you're hoping that, you know, somehow, some way, whether it's a hit by pitch, a walk, something bad happens, because outside of that, stuff is just too good to fail.
Next offering is in for a strike. The pitch. Liner, base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
These guys today are so great with handling velocity. They're seeing high speeds day after day, and a nice job of turning that one around.
One gone, runner at first. Nick Ahmed, the next to hit for the Orioles. First offering, and it just misses.
And he's got deception in his delivery, and it's not that he's trying to deceive the hitters. He just has this natural flow that makes it hard for hitters to pick the ball up. It gets on them a little bit quicker than they anticipate, even though they know what the velocity numbers are.
And it's 1-1.
Clearly all in on the fastball right there, but it was a changeup. Bottom just fell out of it. He's going to have to make an adjustment.
So now 1-2. And now it's even up. Rutschman leads off first with one away. Next pitch misses, and it's a full count.
Now, these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
Just a slow ground ball this time. To second, that's one. Double play. What a twin killing to end the inning. But not before they're able to draw closer with this blast. It's now an 8-4 score. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth, Alex Reyes. He pitched yesterday, and we'll see him once again.
I'm just keeping it real. Nobody knows how I feel, because you wasn't there when I almost drowned in my own blood, sweat, LLV.
Back now at Oriole Park for the top of the eighth. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Spencer Savage.
I didn't even know you, but your brother's my brother. Shout out, Casey.
And he deals. And that one is in for a strike.
0-1.
Yo, one. And ball one. And a 1-1. And there's the strike. One, two now. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. Right-hander kicks, deals, stays alive. Here's the 2-2. Swing and a miss. That one in the dirt. Got him. One away on the strikeout.
The center fielder, number 99, Andrew the Bambino.
So digging in, Andrew the Bambino, a guy who makes an impact not just at the plate, but also in the field. And the first pitch misses in the dirt. Activity in the bullpen for Baltimore. Peter Fairbanks up and loosening in the pen. The 1-0. In there for a strike at the top of the zone. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And a pitch. In the air, foul off first. Mountcastle pulls it down, and there's two down.
Now batting, designated hitter, Sonny.
Two outs, base is empty. And now the DH, Sonny Song. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Not sure if he was expecting for the pitcher to come right at him, but he got a nice cookie there and just watched it the entire way.
All in one now. Good eye right there. Two down, nobody on. And that's outside. Two and one now. Now that's smacked to right center. Drops in for a hit. Couldn't run it down. Song into second, and he's got a double.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but you'll take that swing and that result every time.
Al Moose getting ready to hit. And first offering is fouled off. Man, it's second. He's trying for third. There's a ball. Throw to third, and he's in there easily.
In this game, you got to take what the other team is giving you. And right there, they were giving him a steal at third base. Didn't check his lead. Catcher doesn't throw very well. So you got to take that bag, get your team that much closer to scoring a run.
Here's a 2-1. And that's outside. Two outs with a runner at third. They say it went. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. Third out, and that ends the frame. And welcome back. Bottom of the eighth. Here's the third baseman, Toby Welk. The Orioles in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at bat out of him right here.
Short hop liner, handled it short. Gathers and throws, and that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth.
The center fielder, Cedric.
So the batting order turns over. Here's the Orioles leadoff hitter, Cedric Mullins. He's already homered here in this one. First offering misses the mark. Kicks and fires. And there's a ball. That one missed. check swing, but he went too far. And it's 3-1. Here comes a pitch. And there's a rocket into the outfield. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. A lot of hitters tell themselves, line drive over the infielder's head. That's what I'm trying to do. Just keep that approach simple. And right there, it was perfectly executed. On time with everything and pulled it into the gap nicely. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Norby in the box with one away as he takes ball one. And the 1-0. Tried to get him to chase on the changeup that time.
Good miss with that changeup away. He needs a ball on the ground for a double play. Minimize the potential threat right here. On the hitter's side, nice job of laying off that pitch.
The next offering misses. And now 3-0. And a four-pitch walk.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Dwayne Redd gets the call from the pen, and he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. And next for the Orioles, Austin Hayes.
Well, no base hits in the series for him so far, and it's clearly been a rough one. You just hope he's not pressing too hard because that just compounds things. It makes the slump even longer. Never seems to help. Never helped me.
Next offering is down low, and that is ball one. Bullpen activity starting up now. Michael Jackson, the closer, is getting ready and perhaps looking at a long save opportunity here. The 1-0. That's through there for a strike. One out. Runners at first and second. Going to count 1-2.
1-2.
Got him. And now two gone.
Well, when you swing through that one breaking ball that puts you up against the ropes with two strikes, you think he's either going to double up or try to blow a fastball by you with the next pitch. Right there, he snapped off another curve. It was the same result as the pitch before.
Ryan Mountcastle, the next to hit for the Orioles. And first offering is fouled off. And a pitch. In the air, out towards right center. The Bambino in position. Puts the squeeze on it. And that's the third out. Orioles strand a couple. They're unable to make a dent in an 8-4 deficit. Jorge Lopez on a pitch out of the pen here. He's pitching on 2 days rest. All set to start the ninth in this one. And now, Lawrence Cohen.
Could be a big moment for him right here. He's sitting on 999 hits. One away from adding a comma to that total.
In the air out to center, Mullins under it, hauls it in for the out.
Now batting, the left fielder, Mikey Cohen.
Now the left fielder, Mikey Cohen. And first offering is fouled off. The pitch. And a foul ball. And here it comes. And down on strikes. And there's two away. Here's a speed threat, Stephen Cohen. And it was a homer back in the first inning that got his day started at the plate.
Yeah, Boog, a two-run blast as fans were just still getting into their seats here at the ballpark. So if you showed up late to this one, you missed out on a big moment early on.
Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Now the 0-1. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Lays out, but it's off his glove. Base hit, and the inning continues. And he's in at second with a two-out double.
Now batting, third baseman.
Oliver the man will hit next.
The man.
Runner takes off for third. That's in for a strike. Throw, save.
Well, maybe he thought he should have gone for a triple instead of a double and just decided, I'm going to take third this way. Definitely using his legs to his advantage right here.
The 0-1. And that one is lifted in the air. Mullins on the move to his left. Pulls it in on the run. And that is that. Back here at the ballpark, last chance for the home team. Now here's the Orioles DH, Trey Mancini.
The designated hitter, Trey Mancini.
The right-hander back to work. And a seed into center, that's a base hit.
Multi-hit game for him now, and with the lack of results he's been having lately, I'm sure he's feeling some relief. Challenged him with the fastball right in the heart of the zone, and he was clearly ready to jump all over it.
So, man aboard, Anthony Santander, the next to hit for the Orioles. And the first offering is not close.
Well, the leadoff man gets on. You want to minimize the threat by playing sound defense. Hopefully the pitcher can get a ball on the ground and they can roll him up for two.
Mancini on at first. Nobody out. Next pitch misses outside. Now 2-0. Left-hand batter waits, and a foul ball makes the count 2-1. Good eye right there. And a pitch. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. and one out now.
That right there is one of those breaking balls that you swing through and you feel like you should have done something with it or at least spoiled it away. But when it's breaking in on you like that, if the spin is tight enough, it can actually tie you up.
And into the box for Baltimore, Adley Rutschman, 1-for-3. Started after it, appeal to third, didn't go. And the 1-0. And there's a breaking ball that drops in there. The pitch gets under it and pops it up. Whit under it. That's out number two.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
Shortstop, Dick. Ahmed.
And the batter will be the shortstop, Nick Ahmed. And that's in there for strike one.
All ones the count.
Oh, now this one gets away at the plate. Well done behind the dish. Lifted in the air out to left. Cohen gets under it, and that is the ball game.
Another day, another win. I really think these guys have forgotten how to lose a ball game. It's been so long since they've lost. I really don't know what else to say. They're just a can't-miss ball club right now.
And our final here today, 8-4. And the road team picks up the win and picks up a sweep. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Chambi. Thanks for joining us.
Our final line score, first for the victorious visiting team, 8 runs, 10 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base. For the Orioles, 4 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 24 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.